The Philco Weber Textile Factory Glee Club Boosters Association presents The Imitator, the Cooler Tuber, our spud with spunk. Today, the imitator tries to imitate a football. Can he imitate it? And now, it's the potato's turn. Oh no! What happened? Oh, the humanity! Can we get a doctor over here? On the scene is potato expert Fritz O'Gratton.
It appears as if the potato simply didn't have the structural integrity to withstand the impact of the kick.
Paramedics are on the scene, exercising heroic measures. All we can do now is hope and pray. Let's take a look at the replay one final time. Oh. Wait a minute. Folks, I'm getting word that the doctors at the hospital wish to make an announcement.
Doctor, what's the prognosis?
Is the patient talking?
Have you been able to restore vascularity?
I'm happy to say that we expect the patient to make a full recovery. That's all for now.
In light of this good news, we feel confident in making our imitator assessment. And now, the potato. He did it! And here he is! This has been The Imitator!
Welcome to Guess That Emoji, where we do math, but not just any math, emoji math. Here's how to play. For each round, one emoji plus another emoji will equal, you guessed it, an emoji. Your job is to guess that emoji, but think quick, you only have 5 seconds to call out your answer. Let's get ready to guess that emoji. Round one, milk plus handshake equals milkshake. Great job. Round two, book plus bag equals book bag. Wow, amazing. Round three, pan plus cake equals pancake. That one was tricky. That's all for today. Thanks for playing Guess That Emoji.
Welcome to Weirdland National Park, in the strange and lit mountains.
Heyo, my name's Hiker Bob. First name Hiker, last name Bob. But you can just call me Hiker. I'm here in Weirdland National Park where things aren't always as they seem. Weird. Well, I'm trying to catch the biggest fish ever!
The biggest fish ever!
That's my Echo. He knows and shares everything I'm thinking. It's kind of annoying!
It's kind of the best!
He's not wrong, but I'm gonna catch the biggest, weirdest fish in this entire lake. To do that, I need to get into the mind of a fish. I need to think like a fish. I have to be like a fish. So first, I must smell like a fish. Next, I have to look like a fish. And lastly, to think like a fish, I have to flop like a fish. Whoa, flip, flop, flip, flop, flip, flop. What? Oh no, birds, birds, I'm not actually a fish. I think this fish flounding has gone a little too far. Help!
Help!
Stay
away, stay away. Help!
That was weird. I guess no matter how much I might look or smell like a fish, I really can't know what a fish is thinking. And I still didn't catch anything. So let's reel it in for a sec. Because even though I tried to know a fish's real thoughts, only God knows my real thoughts. Repeat this after me. I am known.
I am known.
God knows my real thoughts.
God knows my real thoughts.
That's a good truth to remember. Oh, oh, I think I caught something. Well, that's weird.
Hi everyone, my name's Candace. This is my absolute favorite place ever, my treehouse. I come up here to listen to the birds, dream a little, and think. If I'm being honest, I've got something on my mind today. See, this morning was our school art contest, and the painting I entered was awesome, but I didn't win. Lana, a girl from my art class, took first place with her picture of a sunset. And that's okay, right? I mean, it's just that, well, I'm way better at art than Lana. Her painting stunk. There, I said it. Oh, I can't believe I just told you that out loud. I know Lana worked hard on her painting too. It's just that I know I'm better than her. And I promise I didn't tell anyone until right now. I totally just smiled when she won. But is it even okay for me to think that way? Until I told you, only God knew my real thoughts. But I'm pretty sure my thoughts toward Lana aren't very kind. Is it okay for me to feel like that? When I'm having a hard time remembering what's right, I know the best thing to do is pray and open the Bible. The Bible is God's true message to us about himself. My situation kind of reminds me of a parable I learned at church. Parables are stories Jesus told to teach people about who God is and how knowing God's character should change our thoughts and actions. In Luke chapter 18, Jesus told a story about two people and how God didn't just know what they did, but what they thought. I'll admit, it reminds me a little bit of my own thoughts today. Let's look at the Bible together and see how God knows our real thoughts.
The Pharisee and the Tax Collector.
Jesus told a story to some people who trusted in themselves and looked down on those around them. These people thought they were better than others. Here's what Jesus said. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One man was a Pharisee, an important church leader that others looked up to. The other man was a tax collector, someone who was disliked and looked down on because of the choices he made. The important leader stood and prayed like this about himself. God, thank you that I'm not like these other people. Greedy, cheaters, people who do evil things, or even like this tax collector. I fast 2 times a week, and I give 1/10 of all the money I get. The Pharisee in this story was like the people listening to Jesus. He looked like he was doing the right thing on the outside, but God knew what was really going on inside. God knew his real thoughts, not just what others saw. Let's see what Jesus said about a second man who was there praying. The tax collector, however, stood far off. He would not even raise his eyes to heaven. Instead, he kept hitting his chest and saying, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. This man knew that he made wrong choices and needed God to forgive him. When Jesus finished telling the story, he turned to the people. I tell you, the tax collector went home accepted by God, but the important leader did not. Everyone who lifts themselves up will be made humble, and those who make themselves humble will be lifted up. Can you believe it? The Pharisee in the story was a person that everyone in town probably thought had it all together, and the tax collector was the guy everyone would have disliked. But God wasn't just looking at the outside like people do. God saw their hearts and knew their real thoughts. In another part of the Bible, in 1 John 3:20, it tells us that God is greater than our hearts, and he knows all things. That was true when Jesus walked on the earth, and it's definitely still true today. I know I don't think right thoughts all the time. We all decide to do what we think is best instead of following what God says is best. God knew we would never be perfect all on our own, and that's why he sent Jesus to fix our broken relationship with God. God knows the real me, and he knew the real me would really need Jesus. Even though I'm struggling with how the art show turned out, I know God wants my life to honor him in everything I say, do, and think. The way I'm feeling matters, and it's okay for me to admit to God that I'm disappointed that I didn't win. But I shouldn't think that I'm so much better than Lana. God loves us both just the same and has given us both special gifts and talents. You know, I think I'm gonna go now. I really wanna go see Lana and take a better look at that sunset painting. After all, I actually think she did a pretty great job.
Heyo, and welcome back to Weirdland National Park. I may not know a lot about fishing, but God knows everything about us. We can see that in the Bible. The Bible is God's true message to us about himself. Let's see what it says about how God knows everything about you and me. Are you ready?
I'm ready!
Let's check out 1 John 3:20b and see what it says. God is greater than our hearts, and he knows all things. We can see here in the Bible that God is so big that he knows all things, even what we think or feel. And even though he knows everything, he still cares about us. Now everyone stand up and repeat after me as we say our theme verse. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. God is greater than our hearts.
God is greater than our hearts.
And he knows all things.
And he knows all things.
1 John 3:20b.
1 John 3:20b.
That was awesome. When we read the Bible verse, we can know that God knows everything about us. He knows our real thoughts, our feelings, mistakes, and even our fears. But no matter what, God cares for us and he wants us to follow him. I think I see a fish. Let's say this verse all together with a whisper so that we don't scare it away. You ready?
3, 2, 1. God is greater than our hearts, and he knows all things. 1 John 3:20b.
Great job. So, real talk. God knows our hearts, and we can celebrate that he always cares for us. We can ask him for help no matter what. That's pretty great.
You're pretty great.
Hey, I think I got something.